96,000
in Bitcoin, you're in blockchain in 2016. Then I looked into it and I was like, this is going to be the next big thing. I think back then I was telling people to buy an note for 5 years to 2021. It was below $600 then.
Hello guys, today we are asking software developers what they do, how much they make, and how they got hired.
Tell us your name and your role. What do you do?
Okay, I'm Pandit Alabi. I'm a software engineer.
How long have you been a software engineer?
4 years.
Oh, okay. As a software engineer, front-end, is it front-end, back-end, or full-stack?
So, I'm a full-stack developer. Front-end, back-end, DevOps.
Well, my name is Aki Ailara. I'm a crypto expert, a blockchain expert, a DeFi analyst, and also a Web3 expert. I currently serve as the Lisk ambassador for Ghana.
My name is Nur Mohammed. I'm a product designer, the co-founder of Yatsen.
What technologies do you use as a phone?
I use Angular, React, Next.js. Yeah, that's it.
For backend, what did you?
Backend, I use Express, Node, Spring Boot, which I mostly use now.
So for me, I'm not a programmer. I'm not a coder, per se. Yeah. So I use tools like Figma. Yeah, Figma for my designs. Yeah.
How long have you been into Web3?
I would say blockchain in general, 2016. So 9 years. I've been in it since 2016, 9 years.
What inspired you to be in Web3? Tech generally into...
Well, in tech generally, while I was around 5 years old, I used to pick up my dad's phone. He used to leave me with it. So I used to explore. So that way, I got good with mobile phones from a young age. From the GSM era, pressing buttons. So that was how I was good into tech. So anything with phones, several things, I was always like the go-to guy where I stay. And blockchain in general, then I was just at home. I was hearing Bitcoin, hearing blockchain in 2016. Then I looked into it and I was like, this is going to be the next big thing. I think back then I was telling people to buy a note for 5 years to 2021. It was below $600 then. And look at it now. Around $100,000.
Okay, how did you get yourself into tech, or what inspired you to get into tech?
So that was, it started with my first website. It was a portfolio website for my graphic design project on gigs. And I was like, nah, I can't pay for this. It's not about the payment actually, but I didn't want someone doing my work for me because I knew I wanted to have in mind and the design and everything. So I actually built it myself. And from there, I was like, okay, let's do this. Yeah.
How long have you been a product?
Oh, for 3 years, I should say. Yeah.
How did you get yourself into tech? So what inspired you to get into tech?
Awesome. So I think I've loved tech from childhood. I love to play with computers. I love to be online. You know, those times it was more of using it for playing games, and then social media came about and stuff like that. But my early career, I would say my early journey in tech was in robotics. So I used to be in robotics and IoT before I moved to product design, and now we are in Web3. Yeah.
Okay, rewarding parts of your job, being a full-stack developer. What's the rewarding part of?
Okay, so it's sharing knowledge. You know, you get to share, you get to learn, and then, you get to bring your ideas to life, wherever you have in mind, visions, because you get to meet other developers.
Okay, what tools and programming languages to someone study to become a blockchain developer or get into Web3?
Depending on what you want to do is... normally, you can start with our first advice for you is you can start with Solidity. But before you go into Solidity, try to learn web development. I don't know, you learn HTML, CSS, Java, but JavaScript is important. For example, and also if someone has knowledge in C++ or Python too, it will be easy for them because Solidity is a combination of JavaScript, Python, and C++. So anyone that has written any of these three before can easily find it to learn Solidity at a much more faster rate. That's why I see most web developers find it easy to understand Solidity.
Yeah.
Okay. What's the best part of your job as a
product designer? I think the best part is solving people's problems. Because, you know, a product designer, it's not just about what you see as in the design. It's about the research you do and what people actually want. So transforming what people actually want to a functionable, you know, product, you know, with the design before the development is the best part of it, or solving problems.
How much did you make as a full stack developer?
I won't say mine. I would say others. So I say one senior developer, I mean, 96,000 the whole year.
Well, for me, I can't disclose, but for people, I mean, it depends. It depends on where you work. It depends on the level your company is in. It depends on your skills. It depends on your years of experience. So I can't really say this is how much you should make or that's how much you make. There are a lot of things that contribute to it. And some people sometimes are quite lucky to meet companies who are very generous. Some aren't that lucky. But all in all, your skills and your experience should play the trick, yeah.
How much does a Web3 developer make for blockchain developer?
Well, as a blockchain developer, it depends on your job exactly. Okay, we have when it comes to blockchain development, there are developers, like they are the ones in charge of coding the blockchain itself, writing the codes of the blockchain. We have those developers. Those are not like code developers. But we have normal general blockchain software developers. Those ones are developers that are in charge of building projects, protocols on the blockchain. So you can see the blockchain core developers, blockchain developers themselves, they make lots of funds because they are the one holding the platform itself. Then the people building on the platform, the blockchain software developers, they make lesser than those guys. And also, if you're a blockchain software developer, depending on your role, some do front end, some do back end, some do UI UX, and some actually they do programming, like they write the Solidity program itself. That's where the Solidity program, which is being written, is where the other aspects of the software is designed around.
Okay. In terms of hiring, how did you land your first job?
Started with someone saw my work. Yeah, they saw my work, they liked it. Like, I work on this project, started from there. But when it comes to the interview part, I would say learn the current problems and solutions that developers are facing, facing, you know, in this current time.
How did you get hired? How did you learn your job?
I've been in it for long. Someone saw what I was doing. And then someone saw what I was doing there. Then, you know, from one thing led to another, an interview was set up. So during the interview process, they were impressed. Normally in Web3, most people go through a series of interviews, 1, 2, 3. But just one interview was enough for me to impress them. Even though I wanted to say more, they had to. Say it's enough. I have to go now.
How did you land your first job? Or if you land your first job, how did you?
With me, most of the opportunities I get is from people I know. Connections is very valuable, very vital. Yeah. So the people you know, when you're in the industry, you have to attend events as we are today. You have to. You can't be an island of your own. You have to attend events. You have to meet with people. Create meaningful connections. Because these people are the ones that are going to link you up to these opportunities. You have to join communities, online communities, very vital. And it would shock you to know that jobs that people connect you to, not jobs that you look for. If you have connections, you don't need to continuously apply and stuff. Yeah, absolutely, yes. Yeah. So connection is very vital.
Where do you see Web3 going, or the future of Web3? The next how many years?
Let me answer this. We've had several industrial revolutions. First industrial revolution started with steam engine. Second industrial revolution started with the invention of the electric dynamo. Third industrial revolution started with most of all these high technology microprocessors we are using. Now the fourth industrial revolution, we are currently at its dawn, 2020. It's much of a symbiosis of every technology that we have now working together. Systems integration, cloud computing, AI, IoT, blockchain, working together. So blockchain is actually part of the fourth industrial revolution. So this is what will determine how industries will be built decades from now. So as you can see, the future is bright for Web3.
What piece of advice will you give it to someone who wants to get into Web3?
Well, I don't really say much of motivational quote, but just keep learning. Even as I'm like this, I'm still learning. No matter what, keep learning. Even if you make $10 million, keep learning.
Yeah.
You just have to keep learning. You know why?
Yeah.
Knowledge is power. The more knowledge you have, the more stronger you become. And when it comes to getting stronger, there's no end to it.
What one piece of advice will you give it to someone who wants to be a full-stack developer?
Okay. First, know your basics. Then, second of all, work on projects. Be creative. When we say be creative, not, you know, design, have an idea, know what you want to do. Then, share ideas, collaborate with people. And that's actually what Africa needs, collaborating with people. Not for like extra gain, but like for, you know, future gains.
It's you. You are the one. So the reason I'm saying you are the one is in everything, especially product design and all, you are the originator of everything. I was self-taught. I had mentors all the way. You need to have mentors. It's very valuable. So I had mentors, but I was self-taught. That's what I'm saying, it's you. So if you plan, if you have that dedication, that perseverance, you would definitely be where you want to be. Look at me. I started with robotics. I used to build robots, at least, you know. I used to build IoT projects and I moved to designing. I did some coding. I built some, you know, small websites, but it's not really my fun part. And now I'm in Web3 building Fiat Sim. So you get it. So, I mean, all in all, the number one thing or the number one person was me, because I set my mind to it and then I had help from other people. So as a person, I mean, it all begins from you. If you don't prove to people that you are able to do something, nobody will give you the opportunity to do the things. Yeah.
That's it for this one. What do you think about this tech career path? Are they worth pursuing? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you found this helpful, then you are going to like the next video. Click here to check it out.